I would say hate. Just a hate.
War is the
move! Even though we're like we're all fun loving guys. We just, when it comes to Slayer and when we write stuff, it's all about hate. Like other people who maybe have 9-to-5 jobs, stuff like that, and they get angry all the time about stuff, we get our anger out through our music. So once we, you know, we do the music, we get the anger out, we just have fun. So we have like an outlet where other people may not have an outlet unless they come see Slayer. You've heard of that Mayan prophecy that the world's going to end in 2012. It kind of goes along with that kind of idea. Because I kind of believe that. I don't at the same time. I don't know what to believe, but it's like, why would they pick that date? 2012, and you know about the Mayan calendar, they have that long count, it can go on forever. Why did they stop at 2012? And what was it, January, oh no, December 21st, 22nd, 2012, the world's gonna end. Why would they pick that when their calendar can go on forever? So it kind of spooks me. So that's World Pain and Blood, it's just like the end of the world. And I'm still waiting for the next big thing, the next new metal type band that does something different. And I don't know what it's going to be, but I'm still waiting, because everything now to me is, they all play fast, they have heavy riffs, and they have that raw voice, which I hate. You know, I hate that raw. It's like everybody sounds the same. So I'm waiting for something like really new and fresh, and you know, something that's going to like, you know, I'll go, what the hell is that? I would have to say System of the Down, but even though they're not that really that heavy, but I remember I went and saw them live because Rick Rubin, I said, go see this guy, see what you think. And I heard, you know, I saw him live, and I thought it was original, but still, they're good, but they're, you know, not the great band that I'm waiting for. I listened to the B-52s. I don't think people would like, I love going out by the pool or going to the beach and listen to the B-52s. Dun, 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 dun.
I never thought the taste of you.
Well, I think the one thing that I think helped us, even though people were trying to put us down, that whole thing in the 80s about us being neo-Nazis, which we weren't, and like us being, you know, just hate everybody and, you know, whatever, which we actually don't. But I think that kind of helped us more than hurt us, because people thought we were like darker and evil than we actually are, because we're actually, you know, fun-loving guys.
Never thought it'd come to this. What the fuck are gone wrong? No rest.
Once in a while, They'll give you some kind of like upside down cross with all kinds of weird stuff on it, and you're like, wow, I'm gonna put that in my house? I don't think so. But you know, I got a couple in the past, I think in Finland, a couple neo-Nazi guys were going, we want you to speak at our you know, our rally or whatever they were doing. I was like, I don't think so, dude. Like, that was kind of weird. Flicks?
Yeah.
No,
never.
No. Yeah, it's usually horror, science fiction, you know, that kind of stuff. Maybe some kind of good drama, you know, like cop flicks, stuff like that. But no chick flicks. It's like the last drama I got into, I don't know, but 24. I love 24. I'm trying to get Carrie into it.